What's up, guys? Your boys are back. I'm Ryan, my man, George.
What's saying, guys? How you living out there, man? Shout out to the free thinkers, of course, man.
Yeah, man. But before we get into the video, man, shout out to Skillshare, which is the sponsor of this video.
Absolutely, man. Skillshare is an online learning community of educational videos where you can kind of connect with popular teachers.
And whether you're a hobbyist or a master like Young Guru, who's a master engineer who's worked with Jay-Z and countless others, man. The name of his class is Learn How to Mix Music with Young Guru.
Absolutely.
That interests us just because we've struggled with mixing
quite a bit
and keeping the audio leveled and all that kind of good stuff. So that the stuff that we learned from the class, we're going to incorporate onto the channel here. So with that being said, the first 1,000 subscribers of our subscribers that click on the link below will get 1 month for free. So they can start exploring their creativity today.
Absolutely. Check that out in the description below, guys.
Yeah, man. So we're back to Stevie Ray Vaughan. You know what time it is. You know this is crazy. We did Texas Flood, which was fire, by the way. And I thought we did Voodoo Child,
I was
right?
About to say, I think we did Voodoo Child, but we can't find it anywhere. So at this point, we've done so many videos, and we just get lost on what we've done. Because what happens is, guys, we do videos, they get blocked.
Or something crazy happens in recording.
Yep. Or we record half of it and then we can't salvage it and then we're like, fuck it. So we don't know what bottom line is, we've heard Voodoo Child. We've seen that performance and I think we reacted to it. And he went crazy on that as well.
Man.
This is a gentleman that we've been wanting to do more of, but as I just mentioned, that we kind of get blocked with his content. So it's weird. I don't know why. And everybody was like, well, other reactors, we don't know why. We can only tell you what our experience is. We don't know why we get blocked and other people don't get blocked. We have no idea why that happens. I'm not sure.
It's strange. It really is strange, but we don't know.
It's very strange. But we couldn't wait to get back to this guy. He's incredible. He's what I would call like one of the aliens. You know, there's certain people that are just aliens with what they do. They're so ahead of the pack that it's just, you're like, this dude is just completely different.
Mm-hmm.
You know, Ronnie James Dio, like guys like that. This guy's just an alien with Van Halen and shit. Those guys are aliens. So I'm excited about this. Little Wing is one of the most listened to songs.
Yeah, man. This is a live recording of it, right?
Yes. This was July 11th in 1983. I don't know. It looks like it's in Toronto. This is a little long. We're not going to talk too much. So let's just get right into it, man. The great Stevie Ray Vaughan performing Little Wing.
Right into it, huh?
It's either that, but I wonder what his warm-ups. I wonder what his warm-ups sound like. Right?
It's a weird.
You know, like his warm-ups are like a concert.
Yeah.
Like y'all ready? Oh wait, you're starting now?
Yeah. Dang.
I thought that was the song, bro.
That was smooth as hell. I thought you were just tuning up the guitar. Yeah. No, I'm ready to go.
That was a layup, bro. I'm doing warm-up drills.
But on a side note, George and I was actually in the process of pulling up the lyrics because we were like, well, I don't know if this song has any lyrics. And it looks like this is a Jimi Hendrix song, Little Wing. So
here we go.
So I guess this must be like his own version of the Jimi Hendrix song.
Yeah, okay,
man.
So cool.
This might even be more fire than we thought.
Yeah, you know? Yeah. Maybe we've heard it because I've heard a lot of Jimi Hendrix. But, maybe we've heard it and we just don't know. So we'll see. Let's get into it.
He's tuned up the guitar and shit. Just go right into it.
Not on my phone, guys. Yeah.
One quick pause, man. This dude is so incredible, man. It almost feels like he has to feel the music. And I believe that's one of the things that makes him so great, because when you're looking at him play it, man, the emotion comes out. You can hear the emotion.
I can anyway.
It's not just playing the song and like, okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Like, it's not structured. It's so free, but it's still so talented, but it's still so emotionally driven. It's just incredible, man.
He's phenomenal.
You're just watching something that you just don't. You know how people see things in their life, like, man, I don't know if you're ever going to see this again. He's kind of like one of those people to me.
Yeah.
Like, I don't know if we'll ever see another Stevie Ray Vaughan. I don't know if we'll ever see another Michael Jordan. I don't know if we ever will see another Bo Jackson. You know, I just think he's one of those people, you know?
He's a fucking alien, dude. I actually think he's got, like, he's an alien. And what I mean by that, and I said that kind of earlier, where someone is just so great, they're just so far ahead of the pack. He's one of those guys. But, like, they also have, like, this psychotic obsession with being great. Like, I look at, like, somebody like Kobe, who was psychotically obsessing. Even though, you know, we get a lot of flack for this artist on our channel, because we've been critical of him. Eminem is psychotically obsessed with technically putting words together in a way. And I'm like, you look at this guy, like, all you do, it feels like all you do is just practice and play all day, to like probably sacrificing and you know,
your personal life
to be that great, to have that, like, that type of muscle memory and feeling. And it is insane. And look, it's only a minute and 32 seconds in, and we're already like, this dude,
it's incredible. It's incredible, so, dude. Incredible.
Was that functional though, guys, or was he just touching the guitar? Was that functional though, that when he just kind of licked his hand and touched it? I don't know, but the shit looked hot though.
Yeah, you know, and I'm glad you said that, because I feel like he has it all, right? Because, you know, you look at Ronnie James Dio, he's such an entertainer, right? And he captivates you because he's so dynamic. And his music, he just brings a certain emotion.
Leaves it all.
He gives it his all, right?
Leaves it all on the line. Not the last in line. He leaves it all on the line.
Yeah, exactly. But you look at Stevie Ray Vaughan and kind of drawing these parallels here. You look at what he's doing. He's able to give you the showmanship, but he's still technically sound too as well. I think you can't, I mean, if you were a guitar player that could play a guitar at a high level, I think you can't really say that he's not doing something that's incredible from a technical standpoint, but he still gives you the dynamic and showmanship,
the swag,
of someone that may not play as technical, mm-hmm. you know? So
Absolutely.
He's giving you which way do you want it. You want the post up? You want the dunk? You want the fade away? I'm just joking. Don't have me hit
the
you
whole
with the whole shebangy bang.
The whole kit and
caboodle. The whole shebangy bang.
Yo, I didn't say kitten computer. Yeah, no. Might omit that shit. If that is actually doing something, that's disgusting. Because he did it 3 times.
Yeah.
He said, bye, bye, bye.
Oh, I can imagine. One-handed and shit. One-handed and shit. That's crazy.
Call that the arm paralysis right there. I can't even use this shit.
That's hours in the gym right here, man. Hours in the gym. I'm
motherfucking young dope, bro. God damn, son.
I could listen to this all day long.
What the seriously. Fuck?
Steve, seriously, man. Dude. And he's one of the only people. He's one of the only people, man, in my opinion.
I was like, damn, dude.
Like, no. I get it, though. Yeah. But I don't want to forget. That's why I'm
Go ahead. Go ahead.
He's one of the only people, in my opinion, that this list is very, very short in my opinion, of guitarists that can play solos at a high level that I can stand to listen to any time of the day. I don't get tired of them. I don't get tired of the way that they play solos. Because you've heard me say this before on the channel too, guys. A lot of people that are technically sound to me, when they start to get into this solo realm of the song, they just lose me sometimes. Because I'm like, yeah, he played a very, very technically sound, and he could play his ass off, or she could play her ass off on the guitar, and technically, but it just loses a little bit of musicality to me, you know? And when I look at Stevie Ray Vaughan, man, I don't feel that. Even though this is, I don't even know if the song goes like this. I would assume if I was a betting man, the original Jimi Hendrix version of this song doesn't go this way. But he still is melodic with the shit, and he's still in groove, and he's just playing his ass. So it seems like this is a whole, the whole beginning of this is a solo. But I love the way it sounds.
This just sounds beautiful.
I love the way it sounds, man. That motherfucker's just, he's the GOAT. He's I'm gonna go ahead and say it.
Whoa! But dude, he's phenomenal. Honestly, like, and just to add a little bit to this, because this video is he still got a lot of shredding to do here. This dude has given me goosebumps every single time that I've listened to him play. You know what I mean? On and off the channel, when I've gone back and looked at videos, it's the same exact response. Do you know what happens? That's funny. Is we'll watch a reaction that we did before, and I'll say exactly what I said in that reaction, like at the same exact part, which tells me that there's sort of this innate natural thing that's happening during certain parts of his, throughout the entire thing, but certain parts that really just get me
and it brings out emotion. Yeah, like, wow.
It's the same exact response. Jesus. I'm like, damn, or or shit. This you know, he is going off, man. Shout out to the drummer though. And the bassist too, yeah.
It's all gonna be a transition in the middle of the song.
Can he just do a transition in the middle of the solo?
Jesus.
Thank you.
The new music will return with more from Stevie Ray Vaughan on City TV and Chum FM.
Yeah, dude.
That motherfucker was a national treasure. No bullshit.
Yeah, I'm telling you, man.
He was unbelievable, man. Rest in peace to Stevie Ray Vaughan.
Yeah,
man.
Dude.
Wow.
Dude, you know, when you look at Stevie Ray Vaughan, man, and you look at what he's able to do so easily, man, and I don't know if you guys heard me over the music, I was like, that's hours in a gym. That's just mastering your craft over and over and over and over again, man. So when the time comes, when it's showtime, you could deliver at a high level. It doesn't matter what happens, man. I used to be in sales prior to doing this. And I always tell people you practice in front of your peers, not in front of the customer. And that kind of relates to the same thing. I feel like there's so much practice going on here that it's muscle memory at this point. I mean, I feel like it doesn't matter. I believe it, even if the amplifier blew out and the shit went dark and a power surge, he could still keep going. It doesn't matter.
He'll play some shoestrings or something.
Yeah.
Let me borrow your shoestrings, my man.
It does not matter. And the reason why I bring that up is because when you said he's a national treasure, man, when you it really brings to light how great he is because he's so prepared. And I think that that's really the thing that shines out to me the most when I'm looking at him, man. I'm like, dude, he's just so comfortable. And the only way you could be that comfortable is that's just hours and hours and hours of playing and playing and playing and doing it at such a high level. That transition within the solo was nasty too. When he's like, boom, 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 and just speeding up the tempo, bringing it back down, you know, playing at a soft, subdued level and then bringing it back hard. Dude, it's just... That's too good. There's certain things in life that's just too good. You're like, yeah, he's just another, it's just too good. You know, I feel like another guitarist that is great in their own right would look at that or person that had the pleasure to know him when he was alive would just say, yeah, that was just, he was just too good. Some people in this world is just too good. You're like, that's the reference point. That's the standard. And that's why I say, yeah, you know, I think he's definitely one of the best to ever do it, but I don't know, man. I think he might be the GOAT, dude. You know what I'm saying? Based on my limited knowledge, based on, you know, Lost in Vegas, 4-year experience. So I'm sure that there's other people that's skillful out there. No disrespect to anybody, man. There's a lot of songs that we did, a lot of artists on this channel that I loved a lot as well. But when I look at him, man, just innately how easily he's able to play these things, man, he's just super gifted, man.
He's incredible, man. You know, and, you know... Guys, everybody's great. There's, you know, it's all subjective. You know, I want to make sure because I know that me and Ryan are both just completely blown away. Every time we listen to this dude, it's we're just blown away by what he's able to do, how effortless it is. There's this feeling that I get with Stevie Ray Vaughan that still feels almost, I know that he's incredibly respected. We see millions of views. But there's still this feeling that I get that it's, considering how incredibly talented he is, it's the feeling that I get is that he's still not quite as recognized or as known as I feel like he should be for some reason. In comparison to some, because I hear Van Halen all the time. Van Halen, you know, and I get that.
Van Halen is great, though.
He's phenomenal. You know, he's got his own, they made a guitar, the V and shit like that. Yeah. Jimi Hendrix, of course, is one of the pioneers, and I hear certain names. Eric Clapton, I hear Eric Clapton all the time. That's talking about great guitars. And I don't hear his name come up as often. Maybe it's because... We started this channel. We do like rock and metal and this and that, and that's just kind of what one of our main demographics that we cover. So naturally, people are going to bring up those guys in that world more so.
Mm-hmm.
But this guy deserves to be mentioned amongst the greatest of the greats who have ever picked up a guitar in all the time. Shout out to everybody that's been requesting Stevie Ray Vaughan. Hopefully, this was the right choice. I have a feeling that it was. I feel like this is a pure blues. On steroids, you know what I mean? This is,
dude.
When I think of blues, like pure, not like the commercialized form of blues, but pure, coming from the soul, I think of something like this, man. Salute to a GOAT.
The late great.
That's the end of the video, guys. If you enjoyed it, please hit the like button. If you haven't subscribed, please subscribe. And also, guys, check out our Patreon channel. If you're interested, it will allow you to get exclusive access to our content. The link for that will be in the description. I'm George. That's Ryan, Las Vegas.
We out.
We out.